Hi guys, and welcome to this next video in the Flight Controller Therapy series. This is a series primarily aimed at new pilots to the RC hobby. You may have come from quads, but you probably know quite a bit of this already, but this is for newbies really. So in this episode, we're going to be looking at flight modes, and we're going to be talking primarily about iNav, but I've also done a cross-reference to RGPilot and Vector, so we can see where the crossovers happen. One thing I've noticed a lot is that people just seem to reference all different uses of the switches as flight modes, when in fact there's actually a few different subsets. So there's the basic flight modes, which are for controlling the aircraft itself, and then you also get navigation modes, which are things like cruise, waypoint missions, that sort of thing, and then you also get tuning modes, stuff like auto trim. So it's quite handy to separate those things out in your head, because when you're talking about flight modes in iNav, you're really just talking about manual, acro, horizon, and angle. They are your main flight modes. Everything else is actually a bolt-on to one of those initial flight modes, with the exception of the tuning stuff. So the first thing I'll do is I'll go into manual. So this is basically a pass-through flight mode. It used to be called pass-through in, I believe it was before iNav 1.8.1. It was actually just called pass-through, but now it's been brought up to date and it's called manual. But what it does is it passes the input from your control sticks straight out to the servos. There's no stabilization in this mode. It's as raw as you can get with the flight controller. So building on that, we have the next flight mode, which is known as acro or sometimes rate mode. There's a little bit of a confusion where people call it air mode. It's not actually air mode. We'll talk about air mode later, but air mode is basically a bolt-on. The actual flight mode is acro or rate. And what this does is add base stabilization, so it enables the PID loop on the control inputs. So it will smooth out if you get buffeting from wind, that sort of thing. So there's no other limits on it. You can roll and pitch as fast as your model will allow you. There's a little bit of stabilization on there, and you can obviously tune that. The next mode I'm going to talk about is called angle. Now, on the scheme of things, angle would actually come below a mode that's sort of in the middle of the two, but it makes more sense to talk about it first. Angle actually introduces self-leveling. So as well as the stabilization that you have in acro mode, you now have self-leveling. So as soon as you let go of the stick, the model will get itself level in both the pitch and the roll axis so that it will just fly straight. So this is a great mode for learning in. The other thing with angle is, no matter how hard you pull the stick over, there's a limit to the angles, hence the name, that the aircraft will go to in the roll and the pitch. So you can set them up in the configurator to limit how much angle you've got. So if you're a confident pilot, you can get those angles to 60 degrees or something out there, so you can still make quite tight turns if you need to. But for someone learning, you can dial those angles right down so they can't really get themselves in too much trouble. And then the final sort of actual flight mode, if you like, that I'm going to talk about is horizon, which in a way sort of sits between angle and acro mode. So it still has the self-leveling. If you're moving the sticks a little bit, it still has the limits on the angle, but if you bank over hard, it will actually do full rolls and full loops. So it adds that little bit extra movement out of the model if you want to sort of progress, but you don't think you're quite ready for acro yet. As you progress on, you'll find that most of the time, if you're out having fun, you'll be flying in probably acro or manual mode. But the other modes are useful to have as tools, or if you, you know, want to take 5 minutes to have a drink or whatever, so you can just stick it in angle or horizon, and the model will look after itself. So they are our base flight modes. So as I mentioned earlier, there's confusion between acro and air mode. Now, air mode is a modifier, if you like, to the flight modes. And as far as I can tell from all the documentation, it doesn't just apply to acro, it applies to everything. And what it does on the fixed wing is it will add, at low speeds and low throttle inputs, it basically compensates so that when you do movements, you still have a decent range of movements. How that works in technical terms, I don't really know. Maybe it adds a little bit more aileron or elevon control, but it's the whole point of air mode is so that when you're not moving so fast, you still have a decent amount of control over it. So it started off on quads. So when you had zero throttle, if you moved the stick, you'd still have, you know, a full range of control over the quad. So the same principle is there with air mode. So it's not actually a flight mode. It just modifies the flight mode you're using at low throttle, so you've got more control over it. So that's air mode. So after that, we move on to the more navigation-based flight modes. So with iNav, or with all of these, we have altitude hold, cruise, and 3D cruise. That's what they're called in iNav. So we'll start with the base one, which is altitude hold. And as that says, all that does is when you enable that, the model will just keep flying in the same direction, and it will just raise and, you know, adjust the throttle, I believe, to keep the altitude at the same level. So if you're flying at 50 meters, put altitude hold on, it will keep flying straight and at 50 meters. It doesn't have any say over heading, so if you've got wind acting against the model or anything like that, it could get blown off course, so it's purely on the altitude. So the next one is cruise, which actually does the opposite. So it doesn't really watch over the altitude, but it just keeps it going in the exact heading that you've asked about. So as soon as you enable it, say you're flying at 340 degrees, you enable cruise and it will keep flying at 340 degrees. So the final is called 3D cruise, which is actually a combination of both altitude hold and cruise. And this will keep your heading and your altitude the same as when you enable the mode. You can adjust in flight, so you can roll, you can use the pitch, and you just, you know, to change how high you are and the direction you're flying in. Next flight mode we're going to talk about is called position hold. Now, on a lot of people just call this loiter, and in the other two flight controllers, RG Pilot and Vector, it is just called loiter, but in iNav they call it position hold. And what that basically does is when you enable it, it will keep the craft circling at a set diameter circle. So you set that up in the iNav configurator, and I believe most people set it up to about a 50 or 30 meter radius. So once you hit that, the model knows where it is in GPS coordinates, and it will just circle around. You can change the direction of the circle using the yaw input. I'm not 100% sure if you need to add a CLI command to enable this. It may be on as default, I haven't checked, but if not, there is a CLI command where you can use the yaw input to change the direction of loiter. That's loiter, which again, this is a great mode. If you want to take 5 seconds to have a rest, stick it in loiter, you know exactly where it's going to be when you go back under the goggles. So the final navigation mode that I'm going to talk about at the moment is return to home. And this is exactly what it sounds like. So you flick the switch and the model knows where it was armed, which it records as the home point. And then what it will do is come around and come back to the home point. Once it gets there, it will start loitering around using the loiter settings. Now, return to home is quite a customizable flight mode. So you can have, you can come back at set altitudes, you can come back at the maximum altitude you've been at the whole height, you can have it so it comes back and then slowly comes down to the altitude at home. It's very customizable, and what I'll probably do is save that for another video to go over all the options for return to home. But yeah, all you need to know at this stage is at the very basic level is you flick that switch and it comes back to you. There's some confusion that could, because in iNav there's also a failsafe switch that you can set. Now, that will, if you've set up failsafe to use return to home, it will return to home, but you shouldn't really use that switch. It's just for testing failsafe. And even then, it doesn't really test it properly because it doesn't disconnect from your transmitter. There's better ways of testing failsafe, which, again, I could do another video about. But yeah, the only reason I would say maybe use failsafe on a switch is if you want it to act differently to standard return to home. So if you're just happy for it to come home and loiter, or do the same thing every time, then use the nav return to home function for your switch. You could set up failsafe so that it returned to home and then landed. I personally, where I fly, I couldn't ever use that. But if you've got a big wide open field, then potentially you could use the auto land too. So that's the only time I would say use the failsafe. I mean, what would be the better option would be to have another switch in iNav, so you could have return to home and then land at home. So you've got two different flight modes rather than using failsafe, because it's not really what it's for. So they're the base flight modes. And when you're starting out, that's all you really need. There's a lot more advanced stuff going on, especially in like RG Pilot. But in iNav, you do have stuff like waypoint missions, and you can do ground station control, stuff like that. But as I say, this is a beginner's series, so I'm not going to go anywhere near that. The only other things that I will briefly mention, again, they're subjects that really should have their own video for, is auto trim and auto tune, which you can set up on a separate switch. And what auto trim will do is basically you hold the model straight and it will adjust the center point of the servo so that when you let go of the stick, it flies straight. Now, you need to do this in a stabilized flight mode. You don't do it in manual. In all honesty, when you set your model up, and I always tune it in manual with the trims and then physically adjust it on the ground. And if you do that, it should be fine in the stabilized flight modes anyway. But if you use auto trim, you shouldn't do it in manual. You should do it in Acro or Angle or something like that. Probably Acro is the best one to do it in. Because as where manual is a pass-through, it doesn't use the same servo settings as the other flight modes. So yeah, you have auto trim, and then you have auto tune, which is more about how the model deals with the wind and stabilizes itself, that sort of thing. So that's basically what I'm going to go over today. It's just going to be a shortish video discussing what the flight modes are, just to try and get rid of some of the confusion. So if you've enjoyed the video, a thumbs up would be great. And if you would like to see more and be alerted to when my next videos in the series come out, if you could subscribe and click the bell icon, that would be brilliant. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments section. And until then, see you next time. And don't forget to fly it like you stole it. See you later. Bye.